Good morning, everyone. Good morning. How are we doing? Doing well? Doing well? Awesome. Awesome. Well, I'm just a little low-key this morning. We're doing something special. We've got four baptisms we're going to do this morning. I'm super excited to baptize all kiddos. Baptize some kiddos when to publicly confess that something has changed inside of them. That's what baptism is. Baptism is the public confession of the inward change, of the inward faith. And so I'm super excited, super excited. But first I want to let you know what's going on here at Crossroads, and then we'll jump into worship. Ms. Dana, I do not have my remote, so if you can switch for me, thank you so much. Our Awana program kicked off on Wednesday with, I believe, 46, 48. It's four in a round number, so it's either 46 or 48. Students for our first Awana program. So thank you to the parents. Yeah, that's a round of applause moment, absolutely. Thank you, parents, for entrusting your kiddos with us on Wednesday nights to teach them and train them what Scripture says about them, how much they're loved. They played a glow-in-the-dark bowling game in the sanctuary. I was a bit upset I didn't get to join in, but it's so much fun. And then to watch the kids go from that to just settle in to learning about God, learning Scripture, memorizing Scripture, hearing Scripture songs, it's just so encouraging as a pastor to see the Awana program going. So if you haven't signed up your kids for our Awana program, it's not too late. Please, you can reach out to me or at the information desk is more information. On Wednesday nights as well, we started our adult Bible study going through the Gospel of Mark. We are in Mark chapter 6. We were going through the Gospel of Mark in the spring, took the summer off, and so we're picking back up in Mark chapter 6. In about an hour, we covered a whole six verses on Wednesday, so we're really motoring through the Gospel of Mark. So if you want to join us, just pick up in Mark chapter 6, verse 7, and we'll see you Wednesday night at 6:30. Women's Bible study starts on the 30th. It's Tuesday mornings from 9 to 10:15. They meet back in the nursery or pre-K rooms back down this hallway. If you're a lady that wants to join that and have the time and the opportunity to do that, please contact Cheryl Brewer. Her number is on the screen. We can also get that to you if you need it. So that way you can get more information or order the book that they are studying. We have some people who are excited for baptisms who couldn't be here today. We also have a family that was excited to do baptisms today and kiddos got sick because it's, you know, school and we're back together and we're sharing all of our things. Germs included. And so we've scheduled another baptism event for October 9th. So signups are out in the foyer at the information desk. And so if you have a young one or if you have more questions or something today just spurs you to be like, I want to do that. It is my time to publicly confess something has changed in me, to be baptized into the body of Christ and just let us rejoice and celebrate with you. Feel free to sign up out there. And if you have any questions, just write your information and then say you have some questions and I'll reach out to you and get all those answered for you. Our church app is up and going, and if you have used it, it is phenomenal. If you're a parent, you can do check-in for your kiddos on the app. So on Sunday mornings, all you have to do is come in, scan a barcode, and you're ready to go. It's also where you can find prayer cards, connection cards, our calendar of events. Anything that's going on is in there. It's going to be kind of our central way of communicating. So it's for both Android and Apple. If you go to the your app store and search for the Church Center app, you can find it and then connect to Crossroads in Monticello. That will do it. Let me pray for us and we will dive right into worship. So God, this morning, we thank you. We thank you for what is going to happen. God, we're going to take some time. We're going to celebrate you and worship you and praise you. And then, God, we're going to celebrate and worship you because you've changed lives. God, that's what this is about. God, church is not just about us gathering to be together. That's part of it. It's not just gathering so that we can study Scripture. That's certainly part of it. It's not just gathering that we can sing songs to you. That's important. But God, we come together so that we can be changed, so that lives can change, that we can move from death to life, that we can move from being bound in chains to being free in your name. And so this morning, knowing that we have four lives that have been changed, we're going to celebrate that. God, I pray that our worship is a celebration this morning. That we can give you everything we've got for just the few moments that we spend singing songs about you and to you. And so God, this morning, stir our hearts, stir our spirits. May we worship you with all of our heart, soul, mind, and strength. In the name of Jesus we pray. Amen. Let's stand and worship.
Yeah. Thank you. Your love is devoted, ring of solid gold, like a vow that is tested.
And so what I'm going to have you do right now is we're going to take a short intermission in our service. This will allow all of our parents to go get your kiddos from the classrooms. And here's why. We think baptism is one of the most important things we do. And here's why I say that. Because the Lord gave us two sacraments, two things to remember what he has done. The first is communion, where we take the bread and the wine that celebrates and remembers what he did for us on the cross. And then the other is baptism, where we celebrate the resurrection of Jesus. We celebrate his death on the cross at communion and his resurrection at baptism. And I'll be honest, it's the only two times I ever get nervous in church. Every time I lead communion, I get nervous. Every time I do baptisms, I get nervous. Because they're important. And we think it is so important, all of the rowdy kids need to be in here with us. So, I'm going to pray for us, and then you're going to go get the kiddos, come back. Let's save this row here for families and those who are getting baptized, and then come back, find your seats, and we'll do baptisms. Let's pray. Father God, we thank you so much for a time of worship, to celebrate the truth that we see in Scripture, the truth that we know. And may your name always be praised in this house. And so, God, as we go get our kiddos, may we be excited to celebrate what's about to happen in baptism. God, we love you. It's in the name of Jesus we pray. Amen. All right, everyone stand up, mingle if you don't have kiddos. If you do have kiddos, go get them, bring them back. See you in about 5 minutes. All right, everyone. Let's find a seat. Like you say always, it doesn't have to be the same seat you came from. You can choose a different seat when we move around. That's fine. So one of the things that we always like to do is give preferential treatment to our kiddos, and they get front row seating. So kiddos, you have to ask your parents first, okay? And if they say no, you have to say, okay, no. No fuss or fight. But this space here is reserved for kiddos who would like the front row seat if their parents are okay with it. So move if you would like. Move if you would like. Right? Yeah, you can come on. And parents, you can come with them too, if you don't mind. If you can sit on the floor with them or in these first few rows with them, that's totally fine. All right. All right. And parents of those getting baptized, please feel free to use this space over here by the cross, because we will baptize head this way, face coming up that way. So if you're on that side, you can take great pictures as they come out of the water if you would like. Yeah, sitting on the stage is fine. If you'd like to sit on these stairs, that's okay too. You can do that. Yeah, you can sit on the stairs, that's totally fine. Perfect, awesome guys. I love this. I feel like I need a story. I know, I feel like I need a rocking chair and a story. Yeah, exactly, Dana's got it. She does our stories. All right. So, what we're gonna do is we're gonna call them up one by one. We're gonna ask them some questions. Here's what we will remember. There are a lot of you, okay? And this might be one of the first times they've ever stood in front of a crowd to answer questions, okay? You would be nervous too, okay? So, when they come up, if they get shy, it's totally fine. They might talk to me. I will relay the answers. They might look at parents. Parents, you can give me the answers. That's acceptable too. Okay, so who, does anyone want to go first? Is anyone like, I'm ready, let's do it. I'm up, I love it. Oh, did Owen have his hand up first? Did I miss it? Owen, come on up, sorry, I missed his hand. Come on up, Owen, come on. Awesome. All right, yes, round of applause. Okay, yeah, come stand right here for you. Perfect. All right, so I think people already know because I said your name, but what is your name?
Owen Prather.
Owen Prather. And Owen, how old are you?
11.
11 years old. Awesome. So I already prepped them with the questions, so we'll see. I'll see if they remember. First question. Owen, have you accepted Jesus as your Lord and Savior?
Yes.
Yes. Good answer. Perfect answer. Which, fun fact, is all the requirements for baptism. That's it. We like people to understand, but biblically it's, do you believe? Yes, then be baptized. Cool. Okay, so You said yes. Do you remember when you accepted Jesus as your Savior?
Like at the beginning of the summer.
At the beginning of the summer. Okay, so not super long ago. Awesome. Do you remember where you were when that happened?
Yeah, in the car with my grandma.
In the car with his grandma. I love it. So I've been thinking. I don't... Exactly. Give grandma a round of applause. That's awesome. So I'm just doing baptisms today, so here's my short message. I have to. I'm the preacher. I have to. Don't waste car rides. You have a literal captive audience. Utilize the car rides. Okay, and so were you asking some questions?
Yeah.
Yeah, and she answered them and you just knew. Is that right? Okay, and then you prayed. Did you guys pray together?
Yes.
Awesome. And so are you ready to be baptized? Awesome. All right, so climb on in. I'll move around here. It's up to you if you want to take your shoes off. I would take your shoes off. See if I could be loud. You know what? I'll just be real loud. That's all right. I got one. All right. You next? All right, come on up. Oh, watch out for slippery. Might be a little slippery here. All right, come stand right here next to me. Thank you. And what is your name?
Riley.
Riley. And Riley, how old are you?
10.
10 years old. And Riley, have you accepted Jesus as your Lord and Savior?
Yes.
Do you remember when that happened?
Last year.
Last year. Where were you when that happened?
Probably in my bed at night when I was talking to Jesus in prayer.
Okay, now that's a really good answer. That's a really good answer. Okay, so you were praying at night, and you just, at that moment, you knew that you wanted him to be your Savior.
Yes.
Awesome. Awesome. I love that. So you kind of just, on your own, you were ready, and then did you tell parents the next morning?
No.
No? Did you tell them, like that day?
No.
Like, the next day?
No.
But they know now?
Yes.
Okay, good. That's all that matters. All that's all that matters. Are you ready to be baptized? All right, let's do it. And what is your name?
Grayson.
Grayson. I like big, strong voice. I love it. Grayson, how old are you?
9 years old.
9 years old. And have you accepted Jesus as your personal Savior?
Yes.
Do you remember when that happened?
When I was 7.
You were 7. So just a couple years ago. Do you remember anything about when that happened?
No.
And that's okay. That's okay. But you have said yes to Jesus as your Savior. And again, that's all that matters. I think sometimes we overcomplicate it. The only requirement for salvation is to be a sinner. And the only requirement for baptism is to say yes to Jesus. It's that simple. And he has said yes to Jesus. So you ready to be baptized? All right, let's do it. Hop on in. Your name?
Mallory.
Hi, Mallory. Everyone say hi, Mallory.
Hi.
I forgot to do that with the other kids. That's our tradition. All right, and Mallory, how old are you?
11.
And Mallory, have you accepted Jesus as your Lord and Savior?
Yes.
Yes. Do you remember about when that happened?
I was probably last year.
Last year, awesome. And I was talking with your mom. You're just like asking questions and reading the Bible. And I love, this is my favorite part of the story. You were just reading the Bible on your own. I love that. Adults, take notes. Reading the Bible on your own. And you just led to questions, and then you knew you're ready to place your faith in Jesus. Awesome, awesome. You ready to be baptized? All right, you can take your shoes off, glasses off if you want. Hop on in. You can hold your glasses. On the schedule. I always tell the story. When I was baptized, I was not on the schedule. One of my best friends was on the schedule to get baptized, and him and I were the same grade, and we were getting ready to go off to college, and he knew it was time for him to be baptized, and he got baptized, and I'm just sitting there in the audience, and like, you know, there's a Crowder song, and it says, and my heart turned violently inside of my chest. That's what it felt like. It was like the Spirit was stirred. I was like, I have to get baptized now. So I took my flip phone out of my pocket, my wallet. None of you have no idea. That's for the older people. Took my wallet out, and I got baptized in jeans and a button-up shirt. We have towels. We've got shirts to change into. We do have another one on the 9th, but I also want to give space for when the Holy Spirit does something unique. So if there's anyone here right now who is like, and little kids, you need to talk to your parents first, okay? If there's anyone here who says, I have to get baptized today, we want to give space for that. So is there anybody here that says, today is my day to be baptized? Give it a second. No? Okay. That's fine. But my hope is that this stirs you to take that step to be baptized. Because when you're baptized into the name of Jesus. Yeah. take your shoes off. So, what is your name?
Easton.
And Easton, have you placed your faith in Jesus as your Lord and Savior?
Yes.
Yes? Do you remember when that happened?
I don't know.
You don't know? Mom and Dad, about how long ago did he accept Jesus? Last year? And was he with family and asking questions? Awesome. So he said he got in the habit of at bedtime, reading and talking, and it was at that time that he was ready. He just knew. The Spirit moved in his heart, and he said he wanted to believe, and he prayed together, and he was welcomed into the kingdom of God. And that's, yeah, absolutely. So one other short sermon real quick. Don't waste bedtime either. That's kind of their space, isn't it? That's their room, their bed, and you. They're letting you into that space. They're welcoming you into that space. Take the time to ask questions. So, Easton, are you ready to be baptized? Yeah. All right. Go ahead and hop on in. Sometimes there can be a domino effect. So, I'll ask again. Anyone else moved by the Spirit that today is your day for baptism? I know we keep baptizing kids, but if you're an adult and you've never done it, now's the time, okay? Going once. Going twice. All right, I'm gonna pray for us. And then worship team, if you can go ahead and come back up. We're going to close with a couple songs. We thought it was just an absolute perfect thing to celebrate what just occurred in our church and to sing some more songs. So I'm going to pray, and then after I'm done praying, kiddos, you can go back to your seats, and then we'll all stand and worship. So Father God, we thank you so much for the lives that you have changed through the families of this church. God, we thank you so much that you have given us the privilege to witness their baptisms, for them to be buried with you unto death and raised again to a brand new life. And God, may we as their church family walk with these young ones as they walk this kingdom journey that you have them on. God, they were baptized into our church family today as well. And so God, may we walk with their parents, may we walk with their grandparents, their aunts and uncles, whoever is walking with them. God, may we walk hand in hand, step in step with these families to raise up another generation of world changers for your kingdom, for your glory. In the name of Jesus we pray, amen. Let's give everyone a round of applause. All right, kiddos, head back to your seats, boys and girls. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. And once they get back there, everyone else can stand up and we'll finish with worship.
From north to righteousness for me stands in my defense.
Jesus, it's your love. Your blood speaks a better word in all the empty place heard upon this earth. Takes righteousness for me, stands in my defense. Jesus, it's your blood.
Last song is what matters. If God is not changing lives, we're just a community group. But God is changing lives here at Crossroads. He is. And thank you so much for celebrating with us those changed lives. So this morning, if something in what was going on with baptism or something in the song stirred your soul this morning, and you recognize, I don't know what it means to be washed by the blood of Jesus. I don't know what it means to place my faith in Jesus. I'll be standing right here. Come talk to me. And we'll get you ready for baptism on the 9th. I love each and every one of you. Thank you so much for coming this morning. Go with joy at what God has done in your midst this morning. I love you guys. See you next week. We'll start our series on the Lord's Prayer. Bring a friend next week. Have a great weekend. Bye, guys.